My name is James Redford. I'm the director of Resilience. 4 years ago, Karen Pritzker and I did a film, my partner, on dyslexia called The Big Picture. And, you know, that experience really brought home to us the value of telling stories that can be used as a helpful tool for change, because it really helped change the public awareness and understanding of what dyslexia is and isn't. And looking around for our next project, Karen, who had been doing a lot of work in the space of children's wellness, as both sort of an advocate and a philanthropist, she sent me a study called the Adverse Childhood Experiences Study that proves beyond a doubt that the more chronically adverse conditions a child is exposed to when they're growing up, the more their risk is for a poor health outcome later in life. I think most of us would already understand that, you know, a difficult childhood environment, you know, creates emotional issues and psychological issues. That, I don't think, would be new to practically anyone. But this idea that those experiences are actually like a neurotoxin that interfere with healthy childhood development, healthy brains and healthy bodies, that seemed vastly new to me and worth sharing, because more important than this troubling link between experiences and bad health outcomes is the fact that one caring adult, an intervention with caring adults, can reduce that risk dramatically for children that are in adverse situation. So really, it's a biological call for better care for our children in general. Sexual abuse is a very complicated, sensitive topic for anyone in any kind of conversation. Mental illness in the home is another thing that tends to be hard for people to deal with openly, just a sort of taboo against these topics in sort of normal everyday discourse. So I think the fact that the ACEs study revealed how troubling the impacts of these experiences are, you know, it's just that much more important for us to put aside our discomfort in acknowledging that these things happen. Number one, one in five children have at some point in time had to deal with sexual abuse, and one third are dealing with violence in the home. These are huge numbers. We need to normalize this amongst ourselves so we can talk more openly about what to do. Many of my films deal with complicated issues, whether it's technology or science. And each time as I sit there and I see an important story that needs to be told, I'm also saying, well, what's the best way to reach the audience? Because you don't want something important to be a struggle, because if it is, it's just not going to reach your target. So whether it's animation or a certain style, there's usually a very conscious approach. And in this case, it really came down to two things. One is animation, and speaking in visual metaphor, because you can make quick leaps. You know, so, you know, if someone says casually in a conversation, well, you know, it's sort of like, you know, when you jump out in front of a truck. We can relate to that, but, you know, to show that just makes it all the more real that stress is a physiological phenomenon, and often a bad one.